Hello everyone, welcome to the world of nursing exams learning. Today we will study some points about asthma and we'll discuss some of the questions also. So what do you mean by asthma? We are not going to study in a very deep way, just we will refresh the ideas what we have, because this is a common condition and most of you have some idea. Then we will move to the question. That's our plan for today. So asthma, it is a lung disorder that interferes with the breathing. We know that the client, when they have asthma, they have wheezing and they are struggling to get the oxygen. Very difficult breathing. It can cause a serious and recurring episodes of wheezing and breathlessness, known as asthma attacks. Here you can see the picture. So what are some of the main causative agents or the triggering agents of asthma? Some of the pets are danger, those who have fur and feathers. Then some food items and beverages. Then some of the respiratory infections. Then genetic problems, smoking, air pollution. Then chemical and some of the perfumes. Then dust. Then certain medications, stress. So these are some of the causes of asthma or the triggering agents that will exacerbate the asthmatic attacks. I hope it's clear, because it's a very dramatic one and it is easy to understand, you will not forget. Then what are the types of asthma? Just we will see how many types and what are the types. The first one is that allergic asthma. Somebody have a allergy to dust or any the pollens, something like this. Then non-allergic asthma, that is like intrinsic. Then cough variant asthma. Then occupational asthma, something related to the occupational hazards or exposure to some asbestos and some occupational chemicals. Then exercise induced asthma. Then medication induced asthma, we studied that one of the causative agents is that some medicines. Then nocturnal asthma. See, just keep it in your mind what are the types and how many are there. Then the common clinical features or the assessment things that you will see: labored breathing, wheezing. Sometimes the questions, they will give an audio clip and that sound you will listen. So you should understand based on that sound which is the condition or which this symptom is for which medical condition. Something like this they will ask. So the wheezing sound, then sleep problems, chest pain, frequent coughing, allergies, common cold, and the client will be very fatty and weakness, feeling tired like this. See, in this picture you can see how a normal bronchial tube and how it will change once the client is diagnosed with asthma or once it is inflamed. See, in the normal you can see there is a space, it is not narrow but it will easy for the breathing. But in inflamed it is very constricted and inflamed and there is narrowed. So there is not enough oxygen supply will happen and there will be a very difficult, that's why we said labored breathing, client is suffering to fulfill the demand of oxygen. So that's why wheezing and all. So this is the picture, just keep it in your mind. Then what are the common patient instructions for controlling asthma triggers? This is very important, because we know that asthma, it cannot be completely treated with the medications only. The client also should take some precautionary measures and they should get a proper knowledge and they should be instructed with some of the points that they should avoid and they should follow in their daily life. So what are that? We'll see. One is, the first one is, cover your nose and mouth with a scarf on cold and windy days. And stay away from people who are sick with the cold or who have some symptoms of flu. So this is very important. Always try to cover your nose and try to avoid the situations where the people will be more people and the crowded areas, and especially during the windy days and all. Then the another preventing factor is that use dustproof covers on your mattress and pillows. That is very important. Dustproof covers on your mattress and pillows. Then to avoid a dust mite, which consider common asthma trigger. Dust mite. Okay. Then what is the next point is that keep pets away from you. So what kind of pets? Those who have fur or feathers are trigger factors. Like some birds and something, those who have fur and feathers, that will increase the asthmatic problems or that will exacerbate the asthma. And the best fish is good if they will keep it as a pet. Then the next point is that you say welcome with a double layered bag or HEPA filter. What do you mean by HEPA filter? High efficiency particulate air, HEPA filter. This questions, in some questions you can see this word and they will ask the features of this one. Then the next point is that stop smoking and avoid sitting with the people who smoke and enroll stop smoking program to increase the chances of success. Then get the healthcare provider about the medications and other methods to quit the smoking. So this is very important. Active and passive smoking should be avoided, and try to involve in any program to quit the smoking. So these are some of the main preventive methods and some of the ideas about asthma. I hope it's clear to you. Now we will see one question. The nurse is caring for a client with asthma exacerbation. Blood pressure is 146 by 86 mmHg and pulse is 110 bar, beats per minute and respiration are 32 breaths per minute. Then the respiratory therapist administered nebulizer albuterol as prescribed. 1 hour after the treatment, the nurse assesses which finding that indicates the drug is producing the therapeutic effect. It is a very simple question. Directly they will ask a client who is diagnosed with asthma exacerbation and now he came to the emergency department or the medical department, anywhere, the vital signs, everything taken, and the doctor prescribed albuterol nebulizer. After taking the albuterol nebulizer after 1 hour, how we can ensure that okay, this produces the therapeutic effect or this is effective or the client respond to the albuterol, which means client will show some good things in his symptoms, right? So when we will see that good, okay, it produces the medication, produces the therapeutic effect, and client now she is or he is feeling comfortable and he's feeling better compared to the previous timing or the previous situation. We'll see the options. So here we are looking for something good. Keep it in that mind. We are looking for something good. Then only we can say, okay, if the drug produces therapeutic effect and client is feeling okay. The option one is says constricted pupils. Then option two, heart rate of 120 per minute. Then respiration of 24 per minute. Then tremor. Okay, out of this four options, which one you see something very normal or something good? Definitely option three, respiration, right? Yeah, that is a normal respiratory rate. And in the question we say that before the client have 32 per minute, now it's 24, which means it's decreased, it's not tachypneic. That means the medication produces its therapeutic effect on the client. So why other options are not correct? Or why we said this medication is option three is correct? We'll see some points about albuterol, so we'll get more idea. Albuterol is a short-acting inhaled beta 2 agonist. So the category is short-acting beta 2 agonist that is used to control the airway obstruction caused by COPD or asthma or bronchitis. We know that in this asthma or COPD, everything, the bronchial tube, it's very narrow, it's constricted. So this medication will dilate bronchodilation, that is the effect, that is the mechanism of action of this short acting albuterol. The therapeutic effect is relaxation the smooth muscles of the airways, which results in immediate bronchodilation. We said already. Then the bronchodilation decreases the airway resistance. So how it's acting? Once it's bronchodilated, that will decrease the airway resistance and facilitates its mucus drainage, decrease the work of breathing. When they decrease the work of breathing, the respiratory rate will decrease and the oxygenation will increase. So that is happening once a client who will receive the albuterol short-acting inhaled upon problem with the asthma or asthma exacerbation. This is the way it's acting. So if we will see that if the respiration or labored breathing is decreased and the oxygenation is improved after the bronchodilation, which we can expect, okay, the medication is working, it's responding well, it shows its therapeutic effect. then why the other options not the correct answer? That is also very important. Constructed people. This is not something, the side effect or the expected effect of albuterol nebulizer. This is something that usually we will see with the opioid medications like morphine or oxycodone, something like this. So we can, that's why we eliminate, that's why that is not our answer. Then another one, that heart rate and tremor. We know that the client have a tachycardia. Before it was 110 and now after 1 hour is 120, which means that is not showing something good, that is bad, and that is a side effect of this one, albuterol. That is tachycardia. Then this tremor. Tremor also a side effect of the albuterol. That is not a therapeutic effect. So here we should have an idea, what are the therapeutic effects, what are the side effects. Then we can easily understand the question. And weekly, we can easily pick up the right answer. So this much for today. I hope it's clear to you. So if you like our video, please subscribe our channel and please press the bell button. So on the coming days, we will update more videos. You will get more ideas and it will be helpful for your exams. And I wish all the best for all of you. Bye-bye.